Ah, photo camera.
Yeah.
I thought you say video camera.
No, it doesn't matter. That's working.
Well, we can take photos with that one. Just click here. What? You stop. Yeah.
Does anybody agree with me? This is more or less 2 meters. More or less. This is 2 meters. One, two. Okay, so if I'm 2 meters from him, will it be easy or difficult for him to tackle me?
Easy.
Why? Okay, so the distance that I sidestep is
time.
I say 4 meters. If I do this, if I am very close, I step, I get here, I step, okay? What will happen? If I shift now, I can only come past him here. So you can still make a tap. Okay, so I will not be able to shift far enough. But if this is the distance that I step from him, if I step now, look how difficult it is for him to get to me. If I step, I must shift. But the first thing is, we're going to go to the defense, remember now. First thing is, if he's my opponent, I have to take him to the opposite side of where I want to go. If I want to beat him on my left, I have to take him to the right. So I've packed these cones, you will see. This is just for, so that you can understand the concept. So, this is will be my angle that I will run. Why do I want this? Why do I want to run it first to the opposite side? Yeah, get him off, get him to a side so that he's off balance and can't make a proper hit. So I've got to take him to the opposite side. Okay. Second thing is, if I do this, if I take him to the opposite side, before I step, I have to go shoulder. Some of the guys, yesterday for instance, you want to step and you want to do it at full pace. If you step at full pace, what will happen? You'll lose your balance. Okay. We will go to the swerve a little bit later, the swerve there. That's the sidestep, you have to slow down a bit. Just go a bit slower. Okay, so I will come in, take it to the opposite side. I want your shoulders to turn. Thing is, smaller step, slow down. Then I do the step, okay? But if I do everything right and I do this, I step there and I go past him here, will he be able, even if he's off balance, will he be able to make this tackle? Okay, so if he comes here, okay, if he tackles from that side, is it a front on tackle or a side on tackle? Does he tackle forward or does he tackle sideways? He tackles forward, huh? So if he comes from there, he will tackle forward, I will go there. What do I want? I want a side on tackle. Why do I want a side on tackle? Because then I can offload and so on. So if I do this, I step there and I come here, come now with me. Is he tackling sideways or forward? Now he's tackling sideways. That's what you want. You want him to tackle sideways? Distance that he has got to cover opens up another channel. You understand that? But if I want to switch with somebody here, if I come here, I step and I get here and I want to switch, if he moves, look how small the channel is that somebody can come back on. It's very small. But if I do this, if I step here and I go now and he comes with me, look how big the channel gets. So now I can start switching. Okay. And then the last part is, after I step, and the step will accelerate. That's where you get the edge over your opponent. So, go slower, step, accelerate, okay, and then attack. So I don't want this, I don't want anybody doing this. There, run out there. Every time when you after you step, you've got to accelerate and play forward. That's here. Right hand side off your left foot and the other group of your right foot will change. Okay, so I'll show you the side step. So what I will do is I'll run, I will look there, everything there, step and get away. Right. Is that clear? Let's go, we'll start here at the yellow cone. Every time. Without the defender. That white cone is your defender, so all you do, all I want you to do is don't look on the ground, I want you to look up, I will go stand there. Look up. You will run there, step, and go.
Oh, what a...
Try and miss it.
That's right. It's my spine.
That's
it. That's
good. It's good. Oh. Wait, I'm a colleague.
Buddy.
Bring me.
Buddy. If I get here, I step, okay, and my leg is straight, do I have power off of the leg? No. So most of you guys will step to the straight leg. I mean, I have this, and if I get here, there, this is how it works. So, how do I get power on this leg?
That's how you injured yourself again. You know, put a step on the half goosey.
Right, so, this is what I want. I want this kind of a very quick movement, but look at my shoulder. I do this. Right. So, it's the same. You still step the same energy. All you want is you want your weight to come across. So, if I step off my left leg, I will use my right shoulder to come across. Just do that. That's all I want. It's not a slow thing. It's not step there. Okay? The reason why I want that is when you play on a wet field, you will slip. A lot of you guys will slip when you play on wet fields. So if I'm there and the field is wet and I do this, I will slide up. That's why if I'm on wet weather, I do this. I step over my knee. Okay? And then the other thing is, if I want to, when we do the double side step, we finish off with it. If I want to do the double side step, if I get there, I step, okay? And I straighten this leg. I will have too much power coming to this leg, so I won't be able to charge it. So if I do both, if I do this, if I want to do this, okay? So then I can step off both feet. Shoulder. See that shoulder across? That's too wide. That's too wide. That's it. That's big movement. Use your... That's not... That's it. Bring that shoulder across. Go, look there. You've got to take the front in there. That's it. Not bad. Well done, girls. That's it. Remember to accelerate while you're running there.